Mungu afurahi. Hata wewe ukizaa katoto na akamei takaduna kichwa kubwa, akaenda kufurahisha zile kweli, utasikia moyo wako hauna raha. Every time you'll be visiting a hospital, doctors, what is happening to my daughter? Doctors, what is happening to my son? Why? Your expectation concerning that baby is for that baby to grow. Am I talking to somebody? And we have been using the book of Galatians chapter 5 verse 23. It has been our guideline. Galatians. When we are talking about, the Bible says that you are supposed to bear fruits. And not only fruits, but fruits that last. When I just press up. Kwa kitabu cha Galatia Biblia inasema kwamba tumepewa tunda la Roho Mtakatifu. Na kwa hivyo, kama I want you to know that every Christian must show the fruit of the Spirit. Am I talking to somebody? Every Christian must show the fruit of the Spirit. I want you to know that gifts are not with everybody. But God desires that at least you have one gift. But for the fruit, it is a must for every Christian to have a fruit. Instead of hate, a child of God should carry love. Instead of sorrow, a child of God should carry joy. Instead of fight and conflict, a child of God should carry peace. What is the stress at? So you cannot tell me that you are a child of God and you don't have the fruit of the Holy Spirit. It means you have not matured. Tell your neighbor, have you matured? What do you lack? What is the unakosaka nini? Now read for us those fruits.
By the fruit of the Holy Spirit
is love, joy,
peace, patience,
kindness,
goodness,
faithfulness,
gentleness,
self-control.
Against such things,
there is no law. Why are we having Christians in jail? The Bible is saying, against this fruit, there is no law. So if you are a child of God, and you are walking in love, you are walking in peace, you are walking in patience, you are walking in gentleness, you are walking in self-control, you are walking in joy, it means that you are not supposed to be gotten on the other side of the law. Praise the Lord. Now you say, Yona, this is a problem that is normally brought by citizens. And they talk about, I think it's prison diaries. Okay, this is Bible study. Prison diaries. Who has ever seen prison diaries? Prison diaries, ni kwenye wanaenda wanatembea kwa prison, alafu wanaenda wanawauliza, wewe ulifanya nini ndio uko hapa? Ushaisikia story kama hiyo? Inueni mkono tafadhali. Nani ashaisikia? Hata mpendwa ashaisikia prison diaries. Now, when you listen to prison diaries, hata wakiochiwa, anasemanga mimi nilikasirika. Nikajua chupa ilikuwa hapo, nikamgonga siku ikijua atakufa. What is that? They lacked the spirit, the fruit of self-control. Praise the Lord. Anytime that you get your anger, anytime that you get your spirit is going down, anytime that you get your worshiping God when you have money in the bank, and when you don't have money in the bank, you're not worshiping God. You lack the fruit of the Holy Spirit. Praise the Lord. We have handled several of them. On Sunday, we handled the twin fruit. You remember the twin fruit?
Yes.
Which was?
Kindness and goodness.
We say, kindness is the act of showing care, but goodness is the exercise of kindness. Praise the Lord. You cannot be kind to somebody. Akiwoye, alafu, and then namambia, God bless you. You have only shown kindness, but you have not shown goodness. Kindness and goodness are related. They love each other. They are cousins. They are inseparable. Now today, I want us to talk on something that is very crucial, that many people don't like to talk. Humility. Humility. The same humility is what the Bible calls gentleness. Praise the Lord. The fruit of humility. I want you to know before I proceed, every one of us is proud.
Amen.
It's only the level of pride. I'll repeat again. Each one of us is proud. It's only the level of pride. Praise the Lord. And you know what? There are some scriptures. If you read your Bible so well, you realize why you are in the same position that you were last year. It's not because you're not a tiger. It's not because you're not a giver. It's not because you don't love your master. But there are things, there are blessings that are attached to humility. What is this person? I want to talk about two very essential pillars. Essential pillars that makes humility stand. Any one of the visitors there needs a writing material. Go to the office, get a writing material for our visitor. And a paper, This church, we give papers. Who is the protocol? Make sure you get books for the visitors. Hallelujah. Finance department, we need books for the visitors, okay? Okay. Now, I want to talk about two pillars that if you are not careful, you will never walk in the richness of God. How do I do a Mungu anatakanga nini na maisha yako? Okay, how many have been born again for the last like 5 years? Nanga miyokoka kama miyakatano kuenda there. You know mkono? Miyakatano kuenda juu. Haya, nanga miyokoka kwa kabocha kuenda maka miyakatano, you know mkono? Hata kama miyokoka jana nisawa, you know mkono? Okay, nani hajaokoka, atona, hayuko, hajuko ya yuko, uko hapa na hapa, unakaa jehana. Nani ule unakaa hivyo? Now, have you ever asked yourself, what is wrong with me that I have not experienced what other Christians are enjoying? Praise the Lord. Maybe today is what will take you out of purpose. I came to realize that God, if there is anything that God hates the proud.
He hates them. Now, my daughter, Tina hates me, Baya. Tina hates. Tina hates. See, who dislike. Who this? He gonna like. Una this? Kidogo. Like, there is a like. Una this? Like, he hates. I'm gonna have a baby.
Praise the Lord. Am I talking to somebody?
Deuteronomy 8, 11 to 16. I pray that somebody is going to be delivered today in Jesus' name. Deuteronomy 8, 11 to 16, very fast.
Beware that you do not forget the Lord your God by not keeping his commandments.
Remember that, be aware that you don't forget.
Do not forget the Lord your God by not keeping his commandments.
By not keeping his commandments.
And his statutes.
And his statutes.
Which I command you today.
Lest when you have eaten and you are full.
And have built good houses.
And you have built good houses.
And live in them.
And you are living in those houses.
And when your herds and flocks multiply.
And your hands. Wakati ng'ombe zako na mifugo zinaongezeka.
And your silver and gold is multiplied.
And your silver and gold is multiplied.
And all you have is multiplied.
And all that you have has been multiplied.
Then your hearts be lifted up.
Yes, now moyo wako inajaa kiburi.
And you forget the Lord your God.
Na unasahau Bwana Mungu wako.
Who brought you out of the land of Egypt.
Ambaye alikutoa kutoka ardhi ya maiti ya Misri.
Out of the house of bondage.
Kutoka kwa nyumba ya utumwa.
Who led you through the great and
terrible. Ambaye alikuongoza, alikuelekeza, alikuelekeza.
With its fiery serpents and scorpions.
Alikutoa katika zile tatu. Zile nyoka kubwa. Akakuondoa, akakuinua, akakufanya ufanye nini?
Where there was no water, but
mahali ambapo hakukua wa maji.
But you brought it forth. But you brought forth water out of the flint.
Ambaye alitoa maji katika, akatoa chemchemi za mto katika mwamba.
Who fed you in the wilderness?
Ambaye alikulisha katika jangwa.
With manna.
Na akakupatia chakula, wanaita chakula ya malaika.
Which your fathers did not know.
Ambazo wababu zenu hawakufahamu.
That he might humble you and test you to do you good in the end.
Well, it was special. You know what? I've come to realize one of the greatest weapons that the devil uses when it comes to pride and lack of humility is not remembering God. Number one pillar of humility is to remember God. Remember God. After you have eaten and you are satisfied, after you have filled your granary, after everything your pocket has the money, you are ATM has the money, you are Mpesa has the money, you are Swahili has the money, you are KCB has the money. When you have eaten and you are satisfied, remember the Lord your God who brought you out of the mess. Now, I want to talk to somebody who has ever been in a mess. Somebody who has ever been in a mess. Unajua mess ni nini? Mess ni kukojolea kasuku. I am talking about mess. Mess ile ambayo chakula kwako kukula ilikuwa. It was a miracle. Praise the Lord. I'm talking to a man. By the time you get 20 shillings, to go to a kinyozi, it's a miracle. I'm talking to somebody. By the time you put sukuma wiki, which is very cheap, on a table, it's a miracle. But the Bible is telling us, after you have eaten and you are full. Kuna msemo, my mom used to say, alikuwa anashinda akituambia, waho na uberada, ukishiba afunika tumbo. Mimi kuwa nashiba ni nini na msumbua, anaona tumbo yangu imefunuka wapi. Have you ever seen there is a time ulikuwa unalamba sahani?
Now let's talk now. Ulikuwa unalamba sahani. Unakula chakula mpaka unalamba sahani.
Sasa sahi umebarikiwa unaacha kamchele kando.
That's pride. It is pride.
I am full. Kuna wakati mwingine hata kuku ilikuwa inalakulani. Mchele penye umekulia hata ndondo moja itadondoka. Haitadondoka. Am I talking to somebody? There are times that eating and drinking chai ya maziwa kwako was a miracle. Am I talking to somebody? It was a miracle. Sasa hivi kienda kwa jina sema, "Kai, hii chai inakaa kama rangi ya umbwa." Kwa sababu gani? Unasema maziwa nono. Ukishiba funika nini? Ukishiba funika nini? One thing that hinders us from going from one level to another. The Bible says that the path of a righteous gets brighter and brighter to a perfect day. That is the path of a righteous. Any time that you get your path is not getting brighter, take your pride. Kuna mahali umeinuka. Kuna mahali umesikia umefika. Any time that you feel the church is boring, I normally tell you, and I'll continue saying, a miracle of the altar is sustained by the altar. It is sustained by the altar. Any time that you feel that I think history ya kuamka mapema, siwaweke service nyingine ya saa 6. Kiburi. Kukianza kunyesha, unasikia kunanyesha. Mimi siwezi enda kanisa. Kama ni kwa kuindi ungeenda. Kama ni kwa kuindi ungeenda. Aka umejenga nyumba smart, umeishi vizuri. Sasa ndio unasema, hebu uliza nani hapo kwa mlango. Unaapisha mlango. Anasema, "Mam, kale kama makasumbufu kwa kanisa kanuta. Kaambia tulihama sasa ni estate. Ani ngoja church. Any time that you feel your pastor cannot fit in your fold. Unataka kufanya vitu kivyako, basi akikupigia simu you are like, sasa tena ni mazile masaile. Hajui nilipromotiwa mimi supervisor. I want you to know, ukiwa na cheo yako, when it comes to God, you are still a child of God. Praise the Lord. You may be a headmaster. You may be a director like me. When it comes to God, you are still a child of God. Put down your ego. Serve the Lord. Put down your ego. Go wash the toilet. Put down your ego. Wipe up on this mucus. That is you are forgetting about where he has brought you from. Kiburi inaingia. Unajua hapo pia sasa wanasema, unajua mimi, by the way ni slangi nyama haina soup na si kuringa. Unajua? Unajua hapo tu hapo kwa statement eh? Na si maringo. Oya, ni maringo ni venye imekosea mahali pa kutokea. Imetokea kwa mdomo. Praise the Lord. Number one, Peter. Remember your God. Number two, work on your character. Humility is working on your character. And what are those things? Can you read for us? Proverbs 18:16. I want to show somebody. What? Why God is not concerned?
gift.
A man's gift
makes room for him.
And brings him
before great men.
Now I want you to know, God is not concerned with your anointing. God is not concerned with the car that you drive. The Bible is telling us a man's gift will make you sit under mighty men. So what you need on this earth is men. And so if your character cannot enable you to stay with people, you are proud. When is this person? Shemejiangu tunambiananga nini? Ya ni mama wakuosha nguo. Mimi nafanya bank. Tunambiana? Tunambiana? You know that family that is in the family setup. Anytime that you see. Ushe yona familia zine zikona levels. This is not Bible study. Ushe yona familia zine zikona levels. I am talking about levels. Paka ya wanyo wanyolewa huko. Pura kenyo wana associating. Unasikia wakulizana. Christmas rene na gaibia ni home. That is a pride. It's a spirit of pride. In a church that we have levels, there is pride. When you are praise and worship, you are a banga hivi. Kuna penye wao uva. When you are talking about your praise and worship, but you are a suti article. I say, hey, you are a suti jo. Hey, your church kuna ma levels. Kuna penye wanaongeshango na pastor after service. Na kuna penye pastor every hand. Ushaiyena kanisa fulani wengi wanaombewa. Pepo zinatolewa. Pastor Potter anaweza hati mwenye ako na suti. Na mwenye ako na t-shirt hajui. Pride. Praise the Lord. And we are in the church. The Bible talks about David. David was anointed as a king. And he went back to serve. For 7 good years. In the spiritual name. David was a king. But Saul was sitting on the throne. But you know what? His throne and his greatness was tied on the sheep. You want to become a good pastor, David, your greatness is tied on singing. It's tied on this mic. See, there are people who just want to rap, poop like popcorn. You are popcorning from where? Where are you popcorning from? You want to keep it. That's the reason why. Why do I suppose I could go and make you a ubiri? When I come and kanisa. Your church will recognize gift, yangu. The Bible has said your gift will make you see. What is your character? How is your character? And the church will have the process. I have always said, like, on a scale of party, I might ubiri. Tell the better for 4 years. You tell the better. Lord, he said, let him say. Let him continue saying. What is your character? Praise the Lord. Your character will show humility. Your character will make you sit with kings. I love what the Englishman say, that your character will open doors for you, but your talent will open doors for you, but only your character that will sustain the door. It is only your character that will sustain the door. Unaweza itwa kutana ya wahubiri ama uende kwa harusi ukule kama fisi. Ukule, maa ukule haitepo, ukule. Una watu wanaweza kula, ule? Yono kwa menda harusi, ni kama analipisha kizazi. Anaeka chakula paka, anaeka tumidole, ili kwa kushikilia nyama isianguke. That is wickedness. Praise the Lord. Ama unaenda mahali kwingine, wewe unaenda kuunganisha sherehe. When you look at what they have cooked, you say, I better eat in a hotel. Or you tell them you are fasting. Even if your food is not appetizing, tell them you are... Sasa hivi nini mnapika mashakula? Kuna watu wabasha. Wanaita chakula yako mashakula. They are bad. Maybe I was not in a position to kupika nyama kando na mboga. Unajua ukipika nyama kando na mboga, nyama inakuanga ndo. Lakini ukiweka nyama pamoja na mboga, zinakuwa nini? Kwa sababu ukipaka nyama pindi umekula nyama, all together ni nyama. By the way, you are not supposed to eat more than 3 pieces of meat. Amen. I went to Burundi and I really complained. When I saw chakula hapo na yana vipengele kubwa kubwa vya nyama. Mimi nikihesabu naona tuko 4 kwa meza na vipengele ni 2. Mashaka kwani mimi nakula nini? Little did I know, your You're only supposed to take one piece of nakundeni.
I pray for them.
As the books of Chronicles are being opened, they realize I changed them. Now, any time that you are being called somewhere, what are you offering?
It's pride.
Now, that is what is killing Christians today. Even with your talent, you will die. Unatumiwa manager. There's a time I was dealing with a minister of gospel. And I wanted him to come and minister. And then he asked me, where are you? I said, where you are. And then he told me, we normally charge paretias. Hey! I was like, Jesus! A very great man of God in this life. And I was like, God, no other than you. Why the God has that kind of visitation? Yako! Retias, yeah, you are Lorette. But I'm over. Do you know me? I can preach to 2,000 and I can preach to one person. I can. If you call me to a conference, I will do the same as I do to 3,000. I will do it. I don't care what how you fill my car. If you feel like blessing me, bless me. But the one who called me is faithful. Anytime you bring pride in the ministry, it dies. What is your stress up? Humility is something as children of God to machine for. Kiburi. Kiburi in a kuana kishonu.
Psalms 138:6.
Please write them down. Go and read them. I want us to pray this wonderful morning. I want us to tell the Lord, please touch me once more again. Humility is something that has killed Christians. We are never humble. Unaongelesha mtu. By the time mtu anataka kwa mlango hivi, you are like, guy. Hiyo bado kuna wokovu hapo. Yesu. Bado ameokoka. And you know what? We have been hindering other people to give their lives to Christ because of the way we behave. Our character, it has dissolved. I don't want to tell people, wear what you want to wear. Dress. But make sure someone does not stumble by what you have worn. We say, maybe this is my life. Oh yeah, it is the life of other Christians. It is the life of other Christians. What you wear concerns other Christians. You may be having one of the greatest talents, but I cannot welcome you on my altar. This altar has been initiated by God Himself. It is not an entertaining altar. Am I talking to somebody? You may be having your talent, but your character will open the door for you. Psalms 38:6.
For though the Lord is high,
highly exalted,
yet has He respect to the lowly.
The Lord is exalted. He is mighty. He is glorious. He is a wonderful king. He is sits on majesty. But He has respect on the lowly. He has respect for the humble. Imagine God respecting you because you are humble. Just because you are humble. Praise the Lord. Read for us Proverbs 3:34. Proverbs 3:34.
Though he scoffs at the scoffers and scorns the scorners.
And scorns the scorners.
Yet he gives his undeserved favor.
Yet he gives his undeserved favor
to the low.
To the low.
The humble.
The humble.
And the afflicted.
And the afflicted. Praise the Lord. The Lord gives favor. He gives favor to the humble. Stop sitting. The Lord gives favor to the humble. Some of us, we lack favor. When you ask, tunakosa kibali kwa sababu, tumeshindwa kunyenyekea. Tumeshindwa kunyenyekea. Ukikuta upata mhubiri, akona miaka michache kukuliko, you are like, just a boy. I want you to know, you may be intimate, but not Christmas. I may be your intimate, but I'm not your Christmas. I carry grace. You don't carry grace. Praise the Lord. So, what is making so many people perish is because God has given the kingdom to the young generation. Na mzee anaangalia hivi anasema, "Utu tutoto tuje tunainuka inuka, tunasema nini? Utu tuto." The Bible talks about the old prophet and the young prophet. In the book of 2 Samuel. There was once a young prophet who was instructed to go and pass a judgment. And who misled that young prophet? The old prophet. So my time has come that the old prophet has to pave way for the young prophets. But what is happening? Because you have pride. You are so proud. You are a landlord somewhere. I am just driving my Mitsubishi. You are driving your SUV. You are driving your V8. You are like, what can she tell me? You are failing to understand. As long as I carry the grace of God, I know more than your age. I know more than your age. Praise the Lord. The Lord is concerned. He shows respect. He favors them that are humble. Why are we not getting favored? How is your spirit? Are you proud? I was telling a case on Friday. Was it on Friday before we entered the kesha? And the guy has been drinking all over. Now, and I drink. Do you know whose sons I am? I am the son of Flanny. And you are drunk. You are useless. It doesn't matter the name of your father. As long as there is no humility, you are useless. Why? You don't carry the favor of God. Proverbs 29:23. I want to close.
A man's pride will bring him low.
A man's pride will bring him low.
But he who is of a humble spirit.
But he who is of a humble spirit.
Will obtain favor.
Praise the Lord. His origin is a Muslim. He was a Muslim from birth. And I want you to know that Muslims rarely regard an authority from a woman. Is that true? A woman to a Muslim. You can see how to cook up. But I'm telling you because he is my son. Sometimes I scold him. Sometimes I tell him, Joseph, what you have done is not good. He's quick to say, Mommy, I'm sorry. That's a humble spirit. Usebe, ati ni karate ya wanaume kusema sorry. Wanaume wakutoka kwa jihadamu. Wanaume wenye hawasemi sorry, ni wakutoka kwa shaitani. Ila mwenzako ni wakutoka kwa shaitani. Praise the Lord. A humble spirit receives favor. When I have, whatever I have, I can bless this man. I can bless him. He knows I bless him. I tell him, son, come. I want to bless you with this. So why? A humble spirit. Yes, his foundation, his background does not allow him to bow before a woman. But because he has been changed, because he has been entangled to a different thing, he said, by this way shall I submit.
Unakuja hapa na kiburi yako. Ati kwetu Kirenyaga wanaume hawasabiagwi. Utaenda kuabiriwa huko Kirenyaga, utatoka kwa neema.
What is a special? Am I talking to somebody? Utatoka katika neema ya Bwana. Psalms 147:6. Psalms 147:6.
The Lord lifts up the humble.
The Lord lifts up the humble.
And downtrodden.
And downtrodden.
He casts the wicked down to the ground.
He casts the proud. Anakushika hivi, anakuangusha paka. Ushasikia msemo unasema kwa Kiswahili, aliye juu mkonje chini. Ushasikia? Aliye juu mkonje chini. Kwa sababu gani? Wakati it is very easy for you to humble when you are poor. Am I talking to somebody? When you are poor, it is very easy to humble. You will come to church, you will watch the church, you will sing it. You are poor. You are poor. Wacha tu ushike ufungo ya nduthi. Hey, wanajua mimi ni nani? Shukuzi niko na ukadako, eh? You believe, utashikwa hivi, utaangushwa kama chuma moto. Praise the Lord. Sahi. Juzi tu ulikuwa unatembea hapa na flota, maibuepo. Sahi umepata viatu za kuvaa za 1,000. Umeanza kugrow holes. The Lord atakushusha. Utashushwa. The Bible says that do not start with the spirit and end with the body. Start with the body, end with the spirit. Kuna wale ambao walianzisha vizuri sana. And today they are no more. Why? Pride. Please talk to my secretary. Hata a secretary lama naweza kuombea deliverance. Between you and the secretary, who was called? Between me, if I make Annette my assistant pastor today, between me and Annette, who was called? The Bible talks about Joshua and Moses. Joshua was not a servant of God. No! Moses was a servant of God. Joshua was a servant of Moses. Read your Bible well. Exodus chapter 1. Go and read it. Moses! Joshua was not a servant of God. Joshua became a servant of God when Moses died. Some of the pastors, assistant pastors, unapewa mic, unaharibu madhabahu. You know I can preach better than Pastor Minister. Hallelujah. You know, my mom ever said it's out thinking. Pride. Some of the people who have destroyed churches are the assistant pastors. And you know what? You should know you are not a pastor. You are not. The man of God or the woman of God has seen the gift in you. So your character is the one that is going to sustain the gift. Praise the Lord. So who you are not a servant of God. And as long as I live, I, the servant of God, who called you? Who? The man who is called on this altar is Pastor Israel and Pastor Millicent. The others are servants of Pastor Millicent and Pastor. That's what the Bible says. When I go to Australia, I live with this mic. Oh yeah? Say, by the grace on my mom. By the grace on my dad. You are not operating on a grace. You are operating on the grace that I carry. Am I talking to somebody? Humility. Humility is giving touches. Humility is giving upcoming gifts. Just because you can sing well. Now the praise and worship leader. You want to overdo. Unasikia sauti yangu kweli? Unasikia soprano yangu? Hata siku hiyo nilikuwa safi, siku hiyo nilifanywa nini? Hata nifanya kati ya praise and worship leader. Hata naimbaga vizuri. That is pride. Utanyang'anywa kilicho kidogo uko nacho, kitapewa mwingine. Moses was the servant of God. Joshua was the servant of Moses. The Bible says, when Moses died, the servant of God Joshua, the servant of Moses Joshua, was called to take over. You only become a servant of God if I open a branch for you. Ha! You only become a servant when I give you an altar of your own. That's when you become a servant of God. All the other times, you are a servant of this altar.
Don't say amen.
Well,
read your Bible.
You know your place. I'm here for know your place. Know your place. Some of you are not even going to talk to pastor. Pastor, do you believe it? Oh, more grace, servant of God. Well, who gives grace? Why are you telling your pastor more grace? Are you the one who gives the pastor grace of God? The pastor should speak more grace upon your life, not you. Speaking more grace upon the servant of God. Bible study, kindly, humility. 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 Know your position. James 4, 10.
Humble yourselves in the presence of the Lord.
In the presence of the Lord,
and He will exalt you.
And He will exalt you. The Bible talks about the Pharisee and the tax collector. They went to the sanctuary to pray. The tax collector knelt on a corner, and the Pharisee was praying from a corner. The Pharisee was proud. He was speaking of the things he has done. Oh God, you know I am a giver. I am the one who built that toilet. God, you know, even the superstar is running. I'm the one who brought it. Oh, God, you know. And the tax man was like, God, forgive me. I am a sinner. I don't qualify. I know I'm not worthy. Oh, God, never ever pray your prayer saying I'm not like flying. Praise the Lord. The Pharisee was saying, I am not like that tax collector. God, I am good. The seats that have been sat on, I'm the one who bought. It means you're proud. No, no, your glasses, Pastor, I'm not even there. Mukitua kwenye nimetua hii church. Mukitua. No, your pastor, I'm not even there. I'm not even there. I'm not even there. I'm not even there. That is pride. It has already been written in the books of Chronicles. Keep quiet. You don't need to know. Even if I eat from your house, keep quiet. To perceive. And I told you, I just did to remember that who told you? Come and take it. By the way, I want you to know that your gifting, your tithe, should benefit your man of God. Whatever he does with it, leave it. Hata kinunua tukutukutano, akuja zieke hapa moja ya katotoka mdogo, hiyo ingine wachana nayo. Your tithe is your pastor's heritage. So unaanza kusema, I still see to memuinua. I want a kitu. Oya, unajua nini? Daudi hakuinuliwa wakati alikuja kuwa mfalme. Daudi alinunuliwa kama bado anachunga mbuzi. You may think right now that you are lifting the man of God. And that is what is making people lose church. They are losing the blessings of God. You may think that you are lifting the man of God. He was lifted before he came to the altar. He was lifted. Before this church began, we had done ministry for 17 years. Were we not lifted? It's only that we were hidden. The goodness of the gold is hidden under the coal. Praise the Lord. For you to know the goodness of that coal, you must remove the coal. We were in the process of removing the coal. Now, after the gold appear, you are the creator of the gold. Look at you. May the Lord deal with our spirit. Luke 1:52. Let the Lord deal with our spirit. That spirit of not being humble, it is making us destroy other people's ministries. It is making pastors to Praise the Lord. And it is a gift. I want you to know, before you blab with a gift, remember the giver of the gift. He can take it away from you. He can take it. He's not a man to lie. He can take the gift away.
He has put down the mighty from their throne.
He has put down the mighty from their throne.
And exalted those of low degree.
And exalted those of low degree. Praise the Lord. I have seen people who have humbled themselves from becoming cleaners, and today they are managers. I've seen people who have been lifted from becoming supervisors, and today they are CEOs. Praise the Lord. The only thing that starts from top to down is a grave. Kwa hivyo kama nataka kuanza juu kienda chini, ni kaburi peke yake. Hata mtu kipanda, upani juu chini, unapanda chini juu. The only thing that starts from the top is a grave. How is your spirit? Humble spirit. A spirit that can accommodate everybody. I normally tell God, give us a spirit to humble. That even when this church, we get 4,000 members, we do 4 services on a Sunday, I'll be in a position to see you people. That is my spirit. Never at any one time will I tell you I'm not available. Why? I am a servant after God's heart. You have been called. You are a servant of the people. Praise the Lord. I know there are people who can misuse grace. They can misuse grace. But I want to let you know that I am praying with all audacity that God may help us to humble. Let me tell you one thing. Don't allow the issues of life to humble you. Humble yourself before the issues of life. Never allow the issues of life to humble you. Sisi kia mwanambiwa, hey, nabeya nikuwa. Hey, wani maisha ina mshusha. Sisi kia tifama ye. Uzuwari kumani. Wewe mwenyewe shusha maisha.
Zawadi ama kile Mungu ameweka katika mikono yao ni manabii.